Hello, all of our White Lake Township Library patrons. We are here to share some exciting news about our new library calendar that will be coming out on April 15th. This calendar will replace our current events calendar where you can go to register for programs and see anything that is upcoming. So we're going to go through our new calendar and show you how it works so that you are all prepared for the switch when it comes over. So this is what our new calendar will look like. Up at the top here, you'll have links for the library website, the calendar, which we're looking at right now, and room reservations as well. Library website will just take you right to our homepage of our website. Events calendar is where we are now, and room reservations will take you to the information about how to go about renting our rooms, what the rates are, and all of that information. So looking at our events calendar, we're going to look at April for the time being. This new calendar will go live on April 15th. So the first couple programs will be over by the time it does go live, but the back half of April and moving into summer will be available for you to see. So just scrolling through, it'll show you the calendar of events. Everything will be listed out for the month. They are color-coded, so if you look on the left here, there is a filter section. Our babies and toddlers programs are yellow, children are this light blue, teen programs are orange, the adult programs are a teal color, and the everyone or family programs is a dark blue color. So you can go through and filter if you just wanted to look at teen programming. It'll pull through and show you everything that teens are eligible for. In addition, with the age group breakdowns, we do have the overall age categories, but then babies and toddlers and children are broken down a little bit further to the specific grades. Under children, you can see both school age and tween do consider third, fourth, and fifth grade, where teen is third through fifth, school age is K through fifth. So if you're looking for a program for your fourth grader, you could select both of those two and it would pull up anything that has those two markers on it. Same thing with babies and toddlers. If you have a 2.5-year-old and you want to see what programs they can go to, you can select just the individual toddler button because you do see there are some yellow programs there. When we click on that one, it does say there are no events available, but that is because the programs that we have that are open for babies and toddlers just have the general babies and toddlers selector because they're open to birth through 3 years old. So if you click on a button and it says there are no events available, you might just have to select that overarching category to pull up the options you have there. Some of the other filters available are program type. If you are looking for just arts and craft theme programs, just book clubs, story times, outdoor events, you can filter by those as well. All of our programs will have a program type assigned to them, which you can see here. Morning yoga is a health and wellness. The solar eclipse event is an outdoor event. Read and Discuss is a book club. So it'll sort through those for you there. And registration type is just, is registration required for this program or not? For the most part, a majority, if not all of our programs do require registration. So scrolling back up to the top here, we'll look at the events. A new feature with this calendar is if you hover over events, it will pull up this pop-up on either the right or the left side, depending on where you are in the calendar. That'll show you all of the information of the age group, program type, how many seats are available for this program, details, and a couple disclaimers for each program. So our Kids Make It kits do not require registration. So when you click on them, it'll pull up the program description. It'll tell you about what that program is, and it does say there is no registration required for this event. To go back to the calendar, you could either hit Events Calendar, which will take you back to whatever current day today is, or over here above the location details, if you click Month, it'll take you back to the month that you were currently looking at. For registration, you will see a little pencil icon on the programs that do require registration, and right above that it will list if registration is open yet or not. So at the time of this recording, these first couple programs are open for registration, but if I were to scroll down, say Comic Whiz Kids on April 20th, because programs do open 30 days out, it is not open at the time of this recording, but it does require registration. So it'll show me that it requires that, but the registration is not open yet. If I were to click on that program, it'll tell me what day registration will open and give me the details. We'll go into one of our programs that are open and show you how the registration works. So we'll click on Craft Junkies here. It'll tell you at the top this registration will close on the 31st. Library cards are required with this new system, and there are 20 seats remaining. At the top as well, it'll tell you that this program is taking place in the Gathering Place on Monday, April 1st, 6:30 to 7:30. It is an adult program and an arts and craft. If we scroll down here to the registration fields, very similar to our old calendar, most of the basic information. So we'll go through here and do library test. Yes, I have a library card. Put in our library card number. It will ask for an email. And a phone number. Depending on the program, down at the bottom, you can either put in notes or sometimes there will be additional questions based on the program. It is not a required box, but you could put in information here. Another non-required question, but we would love to know, is just how did you hear about this program? Either through our social media, a friend, one of our newsletters, or staff here at the library. And then it'll ask if you are a White Lake resident or not. It's just simply yes or no. Register. And it'll give you a confirmation. You should get an email right away as well with the confirmation and information about how to cancel if need be. Moving into some of our children's programs, which do have more age and or grade restrictions, there's a couple additional questions for the registration there. So if we look at All the Rage here, this program is not located at the library, so on the right here for location details, it'll tell you where the program is located. So this one is happening at the White Lake Township Fire Department. It'll give you the address and a link to Google Maps as well if you need that. For the most part, library programs do happen at the library. The biggest exception is the Dublin Book Group, which of course happens at the Dublin Senior Center, and that'll have that address there listed as well. Same thing here, it'll tell you the date and time, program type, age group, information about when registration closes, library card is required, how many seats remaining, and the most important part for kids and teen programs, it will tell you what the grade range or age range is for this program. So this program is a teen program. Our teens are considered 6th grade through 12th grade, so if you are not in 6th grade through 12th grade, you could not register for this program. Scrolling down, it'll show you the same thing on every program, event details, any disclaimers that we have about the program, and then you'll move into the registration portion. We will ask for an age of the child that's participating in the program. We'll say I'm 13. And the grade portion, again, this program is for 6th through 12th, but it'll show you every option on there. Our options listed are not in school yet, preschool up through 12th grade, and then adults. I did notice for some reason the screen recording did not show that drop-down menu, so just quickly inserting that here so you can see we do have the age range and grade ranges. For grades, it's not in school yet, preschool through 12th, and adults. Ask for a library card. And our email address. Phone number. Any special notes you would have. This program is one of the programs that does have an additional question because this program does require a waiver signed beforehand to participate in the program. So we would just say, yes, I understand. How did we hear about this event? And are you a resident or not? Another cool feature on the calendar is it will default to this month view here that we are looking at currently, but there are other options of views that you could look at. You could look at individual days. It'll default to whatever day it is right now. But if you click on the top here, you can select a specific day, So we move to April 1st. It'll show you what is all happening that day and in what rooms those programs are happening in. So we have Craft Junkies at 6:30. That's happening in the Gathering Place. Baby and Toddler Time is happening in the garage. And our Make It kits are on that day, but they're not in a room. Alternatively, you could also look at the week view, which again will default to whatever the current date is. But if you click on that top part in the middle, you can go ahead and select whatever date you want. And if we go to look at that first week, it'll break down day by day and time all of the programs that are happening that week for a quick view glance. And the final option is this upcoming button, which will just list all of the upcoming programs in chronological order with the dates and if the registration is open or not. If you hover over them again, it'll pull up that information on the side, and click on the title will take you to that specific events detailed programs. Same thing on the monthly calendar if you were in April but you wanted to skip ahead to look at programs that are happening in June. If the newsletter is out, you can just click on where it says April and it'll pull up the calendar as well. You can just move forward and click any other month. And that is a quick look at our new calendar. Again, this will go live on April 15th. We will change over the link on our website, send out a couple emails, and put some information on our old website calendar in case you had that bookmarked about how to get to this new calendar. And once we have that live link and everything, we will send out the information. If you have any questions about how this new calendar system works, if you're struggling to register for programs, you can reach out to us here at the library. Our phone number is listed up top here. We can always register you for programs if you don't want to register yourself, but you are more than welcome to register on your own here at home. Or you could give us a call or stop by the library and we can help register for programs as well. Hope you enjoy the new system. We are very excited to launch it and hope that it works a lot better for our patrons. Thank you so much.